Hello, this is Stephen Wilson doing What's In My Bag, home edition for Amoeba Records. I'm going to talk about some of the records I've been enjoying, either new or things I've discovered or rediscovered during lockdown. And I'm going to start with two brand new albums, just came out in the last couple of months, by one of my favorite bands of all time, which is Autechre. Two albums, Plus and Sign. Autechre is one of those groups, they're kind of always the same, but always different. And these albums are no exception. I think they're 12th and 13th studio albums. And I can't think of many bands that have almost entirely created their own musical vocabulary, but Autechre no doubt have. I can't figure out how they make their music. It's so rhythmically complex sometimes. It's almost like the children of Detroit techno discovered avant-garde electronic music of Stockhausen and those kind of guys, which is possibly, quite possibly exactly what happened. Anyway, they're two amazing records to add to their discography. Perhaps a little bit more accessible than some of the giantism of some of their recent releases, like the 8-CD box set that came out a couple of years ago, which I love, but these are a bit more palatable and in small doses, obviously. So, love Autechre, love everything they've ever done. These albums, no exception. I had to buy this, even though I have these albums multiple times already. ABBA, the complete studio albums, but with a difference this time, on coloured vinyl. And I love these records. I think these are kind of standard for anybody that wants to understand anything about great pop music, how to write, how to construct, how to produce great pop songs. Listen to the Beatles, listen to Brian Wilson's Beach Boys classics, and listen to ABBA. And I really like that they've recreated the inner bags, the contemporary inner bags, where they were advertising all of the other releases that were on the Swedish Polar label at the time, in this case 1974. But there you go, Ring on red vinyl. I won't show you them all, but they're all on different coloured vinyls, and 180 gram vinyl, and all absolutely essential pop masterpieces for me. In fact, there you can see on the back of the box, Voulez-Vous on blue vinyl, Visitors on yellow vinyl, etc, etc. So essential for me anyway, as the ABBA nerd. Another album that was reissued this year was something I was very privileged to actually work on this project. Tears for Fears, Seeds of Love, an album made right at the very end of the 80s. I think it came out in November 89 originally. I bought the original CD when it came out. Absolute progressive pop masterpiece. I was privileged to be able to do a surround mix of this album for one of the editions that came out this year. Not this one, obviously, it's the vinyl. But there was a box set that had my surround mix in it. I just think this is one of the greatest, sort of most ambitious pop records ever made. Coming off the back of a massive selling album, Songs from the Big Chair, which had like four massive hit singles on it, which when they were very much still a synth pop duo, this album broadens the palette. They're working with live musicians. They're working with Aletta Adams, kind of gospel R&B singer, and it has a much more kind of organic palette, but still sounds beautifully produced. Something very 80s about it in a way, but something also very timeless about it too. Partly the songs, partly I think Roland's voice, which is just, I just love his voice so much. A soulful, brilliant soulful voice. And just great production. I mean, they spent 3 years working on 8 songs essentially. So everything is produced down to the nth degree, which sometimes can backfire. You know, sometimes albums like that can end up sounding very overworked and overwrought, but this is the exception that proves the rule. It's an absolute masterpiece. And I've even got the picture disc version that came out too. What a nerd. Huh. Okay, something completely different. The amazing German label Vinyl On Demand this year released a whole bunch of Zoviet France reissues, and these albums have been reissued for many, many years, I think due to interband politics. Zoviet France are one of the original kind of drone, experimental drone groups. They started in the early 80s. It's a field that's been much explored by many artists since, but nothing sounds quite like the original. Zoviet France. This is one of their later albums from the 90s called What Is Not True, but I have all of the recent reissues. Beautifully packaged, beautifully pressed, beautifully reissued on vinyl only. If you have any interest in organic ambient music or drone music, these are some of the originators of that genre. Again, much like Autechre, still sound like no one else really. So again, I'm a big fan of ambient music. This is one of my favourite bands of all time, Zoviet France. Actually, an album I didn't know that hasn't been reissued and hasn't been released this year. It's an old record, but I discovered it this year. One of the great things about being a music fan is just when you think you know everything, something comes along that you've never heard of before and kind of opens up a whole different world for you. An American singer-songwriter called Shawn Phillips. This is his second album, at least I'm assuming that. It's the only one I have at the moment, but it's called Second Contribution. From 1970. I would say if you're a fan of anything like Tim Buckley's Happy Sad or Terry Reid's The River album, which are both big records for me too, this is kind of in a similar vein, albeit he has his own very distinctive musical personality. Very soulful voice, elements of jazz, acoustic folk, orchestral arrangements. Again, great songs, very organic production. It was a real find for me. And I'm kind of curious to see, you know, what some of his other albums are like. But this is fantastic. But both sides have these long kind of suites where various song pieces are connected together. So it has this real sense of flow and journey to it as well. So definitely something to be listened to as an album from beginning to end. So there's that. Shawn Phillips, my discovery of the past of the year, shall we say. Probably my album of the year is Max Richter's Voices. Now, I'm a big apologist for CDs. I don't understand why the vinyl revival has meant that everyone's dissing CDs these days. I still love CD. And actually, I still think it's better for some forms of music. Jazz music sometimes is better on CD. Classical music is better on CD. So ambient music tends to be better on CD. I can't listen to music like that where silence is a very important component. And be confronted with the sound of surface noise, clicks, ticks, inner groove distortion, all that stuff you get with vinyl. And I love vinyl too. I love the kind of physical sort of presence of vinyl. But sometimes music is just better on CD. And this is a great example. Max Richter's voice is a stunning piece of contemporary classical music. He's one of a new generation of classical composers, at least coming from that tradition, but you can also tell he's grown up listening to electronic music. He is definitely a child of, you know, the late 20th century, early 21st century. And he does play synths on this album too, but it is essentially a classical album. It's an example where first time I heard one of the tracks on this album, I knew it was going to become one of my favorite pieces of all time, a track called Choral, which is just sublimely moving and beautiful. There's two different versions of the album in this CD edition. There's the version with voices and the version without voices, the voiceless mix. So depending on my mood, I'll listen to one or the other. But that, Max Richter's Voices, is definitely probably my new album of the year, perhaps along with the Autechre. Also, there was a great Square Pusher album that came out this year. So some great records this year, but that probably tops them all for me. One thing, I know we're doing What's in My Bag, but this one would be more like What's in My Truck, because it weighs an absolute ton, but it is, of course, essential, and it is one of the greatest albums of all time. The 30 LP vinyl reissue of Prince's masterpiece, Sign of the Times. Well, what more can you say about this guy? I've often said I think he's the most talented individual in the world of pop music has ever produced. You may not like his music, you may not like all his records. I don't like all his records, but I cannot deny that there has been no one before or since that had the same eclectic, polymath-mongous talent that Prince had. I mean, the guy could write, play guitar, play bass, play keyboards, play drums, sing, dance, was a fashion icon, and you know, had a great kind of visual aesthetic too. I love the artwork to this new edition, with the spot laminate on the front as well. It does weigh a ton, but the great thing about it, of course, is ultimately the music. And there's something like 45, I think, unreleased songs from the Prince vault. Not all of them are amazing. A lot of them you can see, okay, I can tell why he didn't put that on the final record. The final record is pretty much perfect as far as I'm concerned anyway. But there are some incredible gems that were left in the vault that you do kind of find yourself wondering how and why he felt they weren't good enough to release at the time. And that's the beauty, I think, of Prince. There's almost as many gems that were not included on the albums as that were. And this is kind of proof of that. So if you like this album, if you're a Prince fan, this is absolutely essential. I think for many people, I'm seeing this on many people's end of year lists as the best reissue of the year. And I can't argue with that. The man was a genius and continues to dazzle me even after he's passed away. So there you go, Prince, Sign of the Times. I'm going to have to put it down now because it's so heavy. That's it, folks. I hope you enjoyed my What's in My Bag home edition, and keep listening and keep buying music. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. Bye. And I'm just